This conference will now be recorded.
26th of May, we had this discussion about giving aliases. Then, first of all, we found out expressions, how to give expressions to the columns derived, that is called as derived attributes. Then we have seen how to give aliases, other names to the columns. Then we displayed, we found out writing a where clause, how to write where clause. So how to use dates, numbers, and strings in the where clause. That was what we found out. Then the third session was, we found out how to calculate null values. There's an option called as is null function that we have used. So we checked with that. Conversion, that cast function we had talked about. Casting data from one value to another value. Then generating output. And then we have started with single row functions. So that is what we are studying right now, single row functions.
No, can you just tell me on what dates we had classes?
Well, it is very difficult for me to recollect, but as for me, like the files that I have saved, my record begins with 26th of May.
Okay. So I will do that.
26th of May, and I'll then I think we started on 25th of May.
Okay, we started on May 25th. So there was a session, which you mean that May 25th was an intro session?
Probably. Yes. And we had an Excel demo on 25th of May also. And 26th of May, this was my recording. And then I guess this was 3rd of June was the second session.
And after 3rd of June?
Probably there was no session after 3rd of June. Then so maybe it's today's session after 3rd of June.
So 25th, 26th, and June 3rd.
That I may have missed another file in between, but the last record that I have is 3rd of June.
Okay. I can verify this, and I will create this thing, but somewhere even at your end, since you are sharing a screen and training, so hopefully at least one notepad file we will deliberately create that will add knowledge also, and that will save some key points also. I mean, that would not take time. I like the way you highlight things like typecasting, or you bring in some other programming concepts also sometimes, which are good. So that's just the keywords. If you just leave them the key as keywords and as save as notepad files, and you can share with me, share with someone from Analyst Era, and they can share with me. So that will be useful.
Okay.
Thank you so much. Okay. So we will create start. Let's start. Just create a... Open a notepad file. And
is the screen visible to you? Is this file?
Yeah, it's visible.
So let me just go through these operators. We have seen different types of operators, like relational operators, logical operators, which are and or and not. So when you're talking about logical operators, the priority of logical operators is first is not, then or, then and. That's how it goes. So this is, for example, I want to know all the clerks earning less than 1000 rupees. So there are multiple conditions involved here. So I'm taking help of logical operator AND. But if I change it to OR, the result will be different. They are either clerks or they are earning more less than 1000, like that. And along with that, if at all I am taking something where, let's say, department number not in, let's say, 10 and 20. So first priority will be given to this NOT operator and then AND operator. So whenever you are using multiple operators in a WHERE clause, then you should understand the priority of those operators. And accordingly, if you want this condition to be evaluated first, if you want this condition to be evaluated first, put it in parentheses. That is what it's all about. That we have already discussed, actually. I'm just walking through it. Yes, and then we have talked about this range of operators between, not between, in, and not in. Do you remember that?
Did we write something about it? Did we kind of solve something between this and this, or in?
See, basically, between operator is used to compare range of values.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, for example, let us write without between first. Okay. So, how will I write? I want to write select star from employee where salary, if I'll say salary greater than 1250 and salary less than 3000. So what I'm doing here is basically I'm using AND operator and I am writing multiple conditions here, right? Mm-hmm. So for every condition, there will be a different table scan.
Mm-hmm.
There will be individual condition checking for 1250 and there will be individual condition checking for 3000. Okay, like this, if we can go ahead with multiple ANDs, but then there will be multiple condition checking for everyone. So instead of reducing the performance of my query using this AND operator, I would use a range of operator that is called as between operator. Mm-hmm. And the syntax of this between operator is between lower limit and upper limit.
Mm-hmm.
That's how it goes. Okay, so in this case, what it is going to do is it is not going to scan multiple times for every value. It is going to scan only once. So it will go to a particular record and it will check the salary if it is between the range of this.
Mm-hmm.
So, and then directly it will find the result. So there will be no multiple scans. So that is the advantage of using this between operator. So it will find the values between this range. And not only number, you can also use what I can say. It can be used for different data types. For example, I can say ename between Alan Smith. I know it doesn't make any sense because right now it will take only ASCII characters. But suppose you have a table wherein, let's say I'm a shopkeeper and I sell products of different brands like LG, Whirlpool, IFB, Samsung, like that. Okay. And every product has a code.
Mm-hmm.
Or the better example would be in employee table there are grades. Okay, suppose there are different grades depending upon the salaries, A, B, C, D grades. So I want to know all the employees who lie between the grade A to G. Right. So in that case, what will be my query? My query like where grade between like that. Isn't it? So I can use it for character, or I can use it for date also. I can say where higher date between lower date and upper date. So who have joined between? So you can take it for homework type. I can just tell you to write a query. So I'll be saying, write a query to display employees joined from here. So between 80 to 81. So you should get a list of all those employees who joined between 80 to 81. So you can use this between operator in that case. Fine.
Yes.
So higher dates also needs to be, dates needs to be put in single quotations also, just like strings. Then there is something called as in operator. Okay. It's like multiple ors. In and into bracket, we give multiple options. So how the query will work, where job is equal to clerk, or job is equal to manager, or job is equal to analyst, or job is equal to president, right? So instead of writing multiple ors, I am making this query compact by using in operator. Now, how this query works is basically, it keeps on looking for a value till it finds a value. Okay. For example, it will go to record, let's say first record. It will go to first record and it will find whether it is his clerk, no. Whether he is manager, no. Whether he is analyst, yes. Now, suppose it is like his analyst, okay. After analyst also, there is, let's say, president, like that. Suppose he is not a clerk, he is not a manager, and he finds the value analyst. So record 101 is analyst. What happens is, once it gets the value, the search does not continue till the end. That is the advantage of using in operator. Are you getting my point?
Yeah.
So the moment it finds the result, it stops the search at that point and it does not continue. But if I'm saying not in, not is a negation of that condition. So when I'm saying not in, what it does is, it keeps on checking till the end. That means till the last value. If it is not clerk, not manager, not analyst, not president, that means the record is to be extracted. Okay. So his record should not have any of these values. That is the concept of not in. So the negation is applicable for all these operators, not between, not in, not like. So not can be used with all of these operators. So that is between, in. You know this like operator? Pattern matching. It is a pattern matching operator. So it's like when you want to look for a particular value, you can use this pattern matching operator that is called as like. Let me just check with the table if I have it. I'll quickly create a table. Okay, some needs to be just give me a minute. Okay, so there is some data with me. That is, there are some product codes and there are some quantities of each product code. Okay, now look at this product code. There are like some are beginning with AB, some have percentage in it, some have spaces in it. Okay, now how will I use the like operator on this table P code? That is product code. Name of the table is product code. Okay. See, I want to display all those products which begin with A. That is what my requirement is. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to write a select statement. Select star from, what is the table name?
P code.
Right, P code. See here, if I refresh this from here, I'll see the table that has come. P codes. P codes. Select star from P codes where the column name is code, where code, can I say equal to A like this? If I say it like this, then it will only look for a value A, which is not there. So query has done its job, but there are no such records, right? So I cannot use equality. I should use an operator called as like operator. So where column name and operator is like, and then you have to use two wildcard characters to match the pattern. And what are those wildcard characters? They're called as percentage and underscores. So what is this percentage and underscore? Actually, this percentage means any number of any characters, and underscore means any one character. Okay, so how we can use it? Now I want to start with looking for a value which is starting with A. So can you think and tell me how will I do? A will be what? It has to be in single quotes.
Yes, because it's a string.
Yes, it has to begin with A, right? So after A, what should I write?
Can't think of.
A, and how do I find any number of any characters?
Underscore.
Percentage. Right? So, getting it. So all of them, the product code, it begins with A, right? Now, suppose I want to know, it starts with A, and then let's say maybe we can say, I want to find out all those where product code ends with one. So how will I go about it? Ends with one. It's very much similar to what we have done right now.
So it's going to be percent one?
Correct. Very simple. So it's like percent one. So whatever that ends with one, the string has. So these are all the product codes. Okay. Or let's say, suppose I want to know all those who, there can be any first character. So what should I write?
First character.
Not so first character not... can be anything, but the second character should be B. And after B, there can be anything.
Okay.
So if I execute this, these are these records, which are having B in the second position of their code, right? So like this, or else suppose I want to know the all P codes which are four character long. So what should I do?
Four character long and?
Yes, that's all. The size is four characters.
So,
percent. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Yeah, four underscores.
Right. So like this, you can try, you know, permutation combinations wherein, you know, different types can be explored with. For example, I want to find out all those employees whose names begins with A. So it will be A percentage, right? Or I want to find, or I want to find out all those employees whose departments are ending with ing. So it may be accounting, it may be marketing, like that. Okay, so what will I write here? Where D name, like, what can I say? Where D name like, there can be any name. So percentage, what? ING. So like this, we can make use of pattern matching, a specific pattern that I want to look for. Okay. See, the best example would be telephone numbers, landline numbers. Okay. Let's say there is a column called as phone in employee table. Okay. So I'm saying select star from EMP, suppose. Select star from EMP, wherein phone like, am I interested in knowing the phone numbers? No. I want to know all those employees who belong to, let's say, some city in Maharashtra. Okay. Let's say Pune city in Maharashtra. Fine. So the code is 0 to 0. The telephone, that code is 0 to 0. Landline code for Pune. So I'm not interested in knowing telephone number of each and every employee, but I want to know who all are the employees belonging to city Pune. So what I'll say is, where phone number like, the first three characters are 0 to 0.
Mm-hmm.
That is the code, the telephone code for each city. After that, the telephone number can be anything.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So this way, total it will be 10 digit number, right? But then I'm not interested in telephone number. I'm just extracting a part of it. Right. So I'll come to know about all those people who belong to city Pune. So you can think of such examples wherein, for example, there is a list of flights scheduled, and I want to know which are the flights flying from Delhi. So I'll be looking only for those flights which begin with DEL. So I'm not interested in their codes. Okay, flight codes are not important. Their starting point is important. So they start with DEL, like this. Okay. So now, sometimes that I have to use the percentage or underscore, it becomes a part of the string itself, and I want to compare it. I'll just give you one example. Let's take this P code swala example. Select star from P codes. Okay. I'm executing it. Please have a look at this. Record 9 and record 10. Okay. This percentage is a part of the column. Okay. And I want to compare all those. I want to display all those products who begin with a percentage. After a percentage, there can be any value. I'm not interested in whether it is C01 or D01, whatever. Okay. It should be a percent, and thereafter it can be anything. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So if I say select something, something where, what is the column is code, where code like a percent, right? I want to know a percent, and after a percent there can be anything. So I'm using a percent. If I execute this, it is not going to give me correct results. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
What it is thinking is after a there should be anything. So it is giving me all those rows starting with a. But I don't want all starting with a. I want all starting with a percent. So this time I'm skipping this percent as a wildcard character, and I want to put it as a part of string. So I need to tell SQL Server that don't include it as a wildcard character, but consider it as a part of the string. So how do I do that? Is there is something called as escape. I should use a escape character before using that percent or underscore. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a escape character. This can be any character. Let's say I'm using a slash here. And then later on, you have to also mention which character you used as a escape character. So I used slash as a escape character. Okay. Got it. So what is happening here is this character is now considered as a part of string. So we have escaped it. It can be any character, but generally you should use special characters. Okay. Like if I'm using a character, mention which character you have used as a special character. Right. Similarly, you can use not like. Like or not like, any of them, negation of it that we'll use. Right?
Mm-hmm.
So that was about like operator. Now there is something called as null. Do you remember we have talked about null? They are like handle with care, I told you. Null values are those values which are not available values. So if I say select star from, I think we have done this, from EMP, there is a commission column. Select commission. There are a lot of null values here.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So there are some employees eligible for commission. There are some employees which are not eligible for commission. Right. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to say see, he is not having any commission. He is having salary. Now I want to check if the value is null or not. So how will I write the query? I want to know all those employees who are eligible for commission. Yeah, see, this we have done already. The operator that we use here is called as is null operator. See, for example, we cannot say where commission equal to null.
Mm-hmm.
You cannot equate commission with anything.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So you need to use an operator, and the name of that operator is null, which returns Boolean type of value, true or false, is space
mm-hmm.
null, where commission is null. So it will give you all those who earn null commission. Or I can say
mm-hmm.
is not null. So what will be the result of this query?
Mm-hmm.
What will be the result of this query?
City name cell commerce from employee where commission is not null. Yani ke those that commission is known. Null is either zero bhi hoga to bhi chalega. But 950 where commission is to select e name cell. So all the names will come.
There are four employees who are eligible for commission, so their names will come, and the record of Turner, which is having zero, that will also come.
Yeah, commission is not null because three values are defined, and zero is actually not equal to null.
So is null and is not null. These are the two
okay.
operators which, you know, which identify the null value in the column.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Okay. So we have now talked about the range of operators, that is these operators we have just talked about. Okay. Between, not between, is in and not in. So this is what we have talked about right now.
Mm-hmm.
Rather revised.
Mm-hmm.
So then other
I will go and revise. Yeah, I will have to revise these things because I had this idea that people are gonna come, so I was kind of little distracted.
Okay.
And now they're gone, so hopefully I will have more technical questions and I will revise and So next, next is like next weekend. We will. I will ask you a little more questions. I'll rather share my screen or maybe ask things.
Okay. Now about single row functions that we will be. We have already started with. We can apply functions on the data. There are two categories of functions, that is single row functions and aggregate functions. Mm-hmm. Now, how single row functions behave is they basically work on every row processed by the query. For example, there is a very famous function called as len, which mm-hmm. gives you length of the string. Okay. So, mm-hmm. let's say I want to concatenate it with ename. Or let's keep it simple right now. We'll start with a simple one. Len of ename. That's it. From EMP. Is there any other query down here?
Length of ename from employee, len ename. So I had one request. Can we keep an hour today? Just because we are catching up after a long time, and I am also in this thing, and probably if you are feeling the same.
And no, then, I okay. think we should go ahead, because then we will be losing another hour, right? So
how many hours? No. Excel is fine. And I mean, we can continue Excel because she is going to join. I've told her, and just wanted to shorten a little bit the SQL class, if it is okay with you.
Anyway, I'm not starting a new thing right now. We are okay. just going through the revisions, whatever we have done so far.
Okay.
So it's like I'm working in mixed mode. I am giving you some new concepts and some old concepts I am combining. So it's not all new that I'm telling you right now.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I'm going back and, you know, coming up again with new things. So like this we are doing right now.
But I have one more question. Last time you were doing in SQL Server. Today you are doing in Oracle SQL Developer.
Yes.
Wow.
So
wow. Yeah, that's good.
That's okay. Means it is one and the same actually. Means the ANSI statements they work mm-hmm. The same fashion.
That's interesting. Actually, I want that kind of flexibility, and so that means even I can install this Oracle SQL Developer. Is it free?
Is it open? Yes, it is. It is.
Okay, so probably I will one day I'll ask you how to do that, and probably you can guide me how to do that.
But then there are some commands which are specific to SQL Server.
And maybe there must be some which are specific to Oracle. So that will be fun to learn also, and hopefully you are the best person to give me that knowledge. And so I thank you. I mean, this is a really nice thing.
Yes.
You are kind of expert in both.
No, I'm not expert, but it comes with, you know, requirement basis
I had a general question. I mean, your pace, particularly with SQL, over the period, I wanted someone who talks like slowly and picks up things in a natural, more natural way. So do you know of someone who actually does C++ like you?
Well, I'll have to check here. Why don't you check with the analyst? They may be having trainers because I'm not a C++ person. So the pool of trainer that I know is they're all databases related, the connects that I have actually.
Okay.
Fine. So this is the length function wherein you know you come to know actually length. So the best example is I want to know who is earning in thousands or who is earning in lakhs. So very simple thing I would do is I would say select sal, length of sal from EMP. Okay, so how this query will work? See, this way.
Length select cell, length cell from employee.
Right, so this is 3 and this is. So now tell me if I want to find out who is earning in thousands, how will I do that?
Jinka length equal length of cell equal to 4999 is not 99999 is 1000, whereas 10,000 ho jayega. So if we are more than 1000 ban sakta hai, in thousands would be a little vague, because little vague means mein dalna padega greater than 3 length, and in between 4 digits mein agar karna hai to less than or equal to, greater than or equal to, right? Yeah, less than or equal to, greater than or equal to, between or range karna hai, then how do we do it? I hope you're getting what is going inside my brain.
So can we say where spelling mistake is that? Where? Right?
सेल इक्वल टू 4 डाल दिया, 4 डाल दिया तो 3000 तक आ गए सारे,
right?
49, अच्छा thousands, ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, और thousands के बाद 10,000. So okay, so this is like
length of cell is equal to 4. So like this you can use length function for characters, you can use length function for numbers also. So it will, like that you can find out different things wherein length. Do you remember just a while ago we use like function, isn't it? So I asked you that how will you find out all those names who are 4 character longs. So which operator we used? We use liked operator, isn't it? And then like, we use 4 underscores for it. The same query can be written using length also. Instead of using like, I can say ename. Instead of using like and 4 underscores. So these are all the employees. These are all employees whose names are 4 character long.
Ename equal to 4. Bracket ke bahar aayega. Right, okay.
So this function what it does, length function, is it accepts the parameter and returns a number. And that number is the what? The length of that column. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Now here, the name of the function is actually len, L-E-N. Now there are case conversion functions. They are called as upper and lower. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So these functions basically are used to convert the case of a string. So how they will be used is like select. What I can say? I'll just use normal ename. Then I will say upper of ename. And then I'll say lower of ename from employee, right?
Uh-huh.
So this is my original column. This is converted in uppercase and this is converted to lowercase. So upper, lower, like this.
Uh-huh.
Right now it doesn't make that much, change to my data, but where will be this functions useful is like whenever I'm storing data into my database, okay, the data comes from various sources. It may be coming from, see, I'm storing it in SQL Server and the data may be coming from Oracle, or it may be coming from a CSV file, or it may be coming from web, right? So it comes from multiple sources and we do not have control over the type of the data that is coming into my system, right?
Mm-hmm.
So the requirement of my database is to store all the data in uppercase. So after storing the data and then converting it into the required case, instead of that, whenever I'm inserting the data or whenever I'm updating the data, at that time only I will use this function, convert it, and then only I'll store it.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So when I'm using a insert function, within insert only I'll use uppercase or lowercase. That.
Mm-hmm.
Or else we can just say, okay, just tell me one thing. Will this query work or not? Select ename from EMP. Where? Ename is equal to Smith. Will it work?
Yes.
Okay, let's try. Smith is very much there in my table. The query works, but it is not giving me result right now. Why?
Mm-hmm.
Because of the reason that the data that I have stored in the table, it is what type of data? Smith. You see the Smith's record? It is in uppercase and it is not able to compare with it. Okay, so what I should do is?
Oracle is case sensitive?
Yes, Oracle is case sensitive.
And this thing is the same thing we have done in SQL Server, it would have given us answer.
It would have given us results. By default, it is not case sensitive. You can change it if you wish to.
Yeah.
But by default, it is case insensitive.
Mm-hmm.
It gives you nearest match,
mm-hmm.
whereas Oracle gives you exact match.
Mm-hmm.
So you need to convert it to uppercase. Now it will give you the result. So I'll say ename upper of Smith. So it will first convert this to uppercase and then it will come use. Or I can also say where lower of ename is equal to Smith. This way also. So
mm-hmm.
either first compare and then use, or first use then comparing. Either way.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So like this, you can use the case conversion functions.
Mm-hmm.
Then there is something called a trim. Now, what is this trim? You know that trimming is from ends. okay, either from the left or from right. You trim the values from the left. Now, why this trim function is important is because, see, sometimes the data that comes to you, it gets padded with extra spaces or extra digits, okay? And then it becomes difficult to compare or store such data. For example, if at all the there was a data entry operator and he was entering the record of Smith. While entering the record of Smith, what she did was, I'm typing it in all capital, okay? This is proper. But then what if she has done this? Did you understand? It's not Smith anymore. It is Smith space.
Yes.
So definitely this this query will not give me correct results. And I keep on wondering because I do not know this, right? So I execute this query and I keep on wondering. I'm not finding it. Smith is very much there in my company, but I'm not able to get his record. Why? Because I'm comparing Smith with Smith Spades, which is not correct. So it is the programmer's duty to trim the data and then store it properly. So that later on complications are avoided.
Right.
Okay? So when we are trimming, we can trim from not in between, but from end. So that is the functions are L trim and R trim. That is trimming from left and trimming from right. Okay. So the commands here, they're like, okay. See, basically in Oracle, the from clause is compulsory. Wherein in SQL Server, it is not compulsory. Okay. So to use a from,
okay.
To have some calculation, Oracle has provided us with a dummy table called as dual. Okay. So I can use that. It's a one column, one row table dummy. Its name is dual. So it's like I can say.
So in SQL Server, where we use from, after from, we specify the table name from this table. So. Yes. So in Oracle, how do we specify the table name if from is not required?
That's what. In Oracle, from is not optional. It's a compulsory clause.
Yeah. So in SQL Server, then I'll have the same question that there. How do we specify the table name then if we don't use from? Select EE name from. So if we don't write from the table name, then SQL Server will give the output.
Just a minute. See, in case of SQL Server, if I say select len, now here the function is len, it's not length completely spelled out, okay? Mm-hmm. Len of, if I'm saying hello world, there's some string hello world, okay? Mm-hmm. See, for this function printing hello world, it doesn't belong to any table. Mm-hmm. I just wanted to know the length of hello world. So for this, from table name was not needed.
Mm-hmm.
So I can skip it. So the from clause is optional in case of SQL Server.
Mm-hmm.
But that is compulsory in case of Oracle. You have to have a table name. That is why they have provided a dummy table called as Oracle Dual.
Okay. Okay.
I think we should stick to one database so that there will be no confusion.
No, I would say confusion. Mm-hmm. You are at a level where you can remove the confusions, and that is the kind of knowledge I need. And at the mm-hmm. end of the program, I should be jack of both. But okay, yeah, at the same time, you can say that we will towards the end of this thing, we will try to see where I fit in, what thing I can master, something like that.
Okay. So I'll keep both the windows open and we can switch mm-hmm. whenever we want.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Now, there is a table wherein this data is already there. Okay. That's the name of that table. Ltrim function is there used, okay? And do you know this, the concept of nested functions?
Nested, yeah, loop inside
nested,
loop.
Nested functions means a function within a function that is called
yeah.
a nested function, okay?
Yeah.
So you can put a function within another function. So how they get executed is the innermost function gets executed first, giving result to the outer function.
Yeah, inside out.
Yeah. So when you are talking about single row functions, they can be nested up to any level. Okay. Mm-hmm. You can have a list of nested functions. So as you can see here, there are two functions used here. Nested function. There is an ltrim function. It is used inside len function.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So the first function that will get executed is what? Ltrim function will get executed first, giving
mm-hmm.
result to the len function.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So that's how it is going to work like.
Mm-hmm.
Now we will say select. There is a huge space here.
Mm-hmm.
Right? List. There are a lot of spaces. And then there is some original string, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So after that, what we are doing is we are trimming that original string. So we will remove the spaces and then we will have the string.
Mm-hmm.
Fine?
Mm-hmm.
So let us do this. I'm saying hello world, okay?
Okay.
Length of hello world is what? 11, right?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to give spaces. Fine.
Mm-hmm.
Now the length will change.
Okay.
It becomes 24. So the word is hello world only, but it is the length is different because it is padded with some kind of spaces. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to have ltrim on it. Fine. So I'm going to say select ltrim. Ltrim is the function, okay? Ltrim of what? Ltrim of this string.
Mm-hmm. So you copied and pasted there.
Yes.
So if they have got large amount of data and there the entries have got such nulls, or what are they called?
Spaces. They are not nulls.
Spaces. Yeah, the spaces.
String has got extra spaces.
So the extra spaces in the strings, and there is a lot amount of entries. So every time we get, what do? We copy all of them and left trim each of them how do we do in bulk?
The data will be trimmed. The entire column will be trimmed.
So we can do left trim the column name?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So I'll say execute. And what do you see here? You get only string.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
So now what I'm going to do is, earlier the length was some 24 or something, right? Mm-hmm. Now after trimming, let's find out the length.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. From 24, it has become 11 now. So it removed the extra spaces from the left hand side. And mm-hmm. it only kept this much.
Mm-hmm.
So it only kept hello world as the string. Similarly, mm-hmm. we can have R trim.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. For example, I have this hello world, and here I have spaces on the right hand side. Mm-hmm. So instead of L trim, I may use R trim.
Mm-hmm.
Fine. So now R trim. I will execute this, and the spaces from right will be removed, and the mm-hmm. length of the rtrim function will be, no, it should be this, the string. I should change the string actually from the right.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't it? So it's not 24 anymore. The length is 11 because I'm using rtrim function on it.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So like when you are inserting data into the table, or when you are modifying your table, you should make sure that there are no extra spaces to it.
Mm-hmm.
That is the purpose of it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. L trim and R trim.
Mm-hmm.
So to remove the white spaces from the right hand side or from the left hand side of it.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Now the next function is, it is called a substring. It's a very famous function. It is present in all languages. Mm-hmm. Substring is what? It takes a part of the string from the given string.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So mm-hmm. For example, I have this substring function, okay? Select substring of hello world. It accepts mm-hmm. three parameters, and those parameters, the first parameter is what? The actual, the first parameter is actual string. The second parameter is the starting position from where you want the string to be taken. And the third parameter is the number of characters that you want to extract from the given position. For mm-hmm. example, let's say I want to start with one. Hello. Why is it mm-hmm. giving me hello? Starting with first, five characters ahead from that point.
Mm-hmm.
So to extract a part of the string, I'm using it. Okay. So let's say I want to start with 6. And 5 characters ahead. Or I'll start with 5 and 5 characters ahead. Like that. So these are called as, if I skip it, that means from 5 characters, I do not give the third. That means it, the substring function requires 3 arguments. That means this particular function cannot be overloaded. Do you know the concept of overloading?
No.
Okay. That means I cannot change the number of parameters. Some functions allow changing number of parameters. They are called as overloaded functions. But some functions, they do not allow overloading. If I was using this function in Oracle, it would have allowed me. Okay, so in Oracle, this function can get overloaded, but in SQL Server, it will not get overloaded. Okay, so like this, it can, I can take a part of the function out of it. Remember?
Okay.
So where this will be most useful, basically. This will be useful in cases wherein I want to extract some kind of code from my employees, from any primary key, let's say. Okay, for example, the primary key is having some kind of code, a 4-digit number, and then after 4-digit number, it tells me that that product is sold or that product it gets manufactured in which zone, like east, west, central, or what type. Okay, so it's like 101 east, 102 west, that kind. Fine. So my interest is I want to list the products which are in the, let's say, west zone. So my, let's say, select star from some kind of product. The table may not be there right now. That doesn't matter. But the query will be where P code, where substring, I will use a substring function, where substring of P code. So P code here, the column name I'm passing as a parameter. So it will take P code and then I'm saying 4, 3. What is this 4, 3? That means starting from 4th character till 3rd character. 3 characters ahead, it should be something like this. Okay, so only those rows which has such kind of substring starting from 4th position will be displayed. So I'll get all those who lie in the west zone. Right. So in such cases wherein you want to extract a part of the string, you can take help of the function substring. Then replicate. Replicate function, as the name suggests, it replicates a particular thing multiple times. Say, for example, it accepts the first parameter is actual string and the second parameter is how many times you want that string to be replicated. So you can use it for these many times. So hello, like that. Okay, so I can say select ename Sal from employees. And here I can use replicate function. Replicate sal and maybe what? One more time, something of that sort. One, okay, like this. So it will keep on replicating those many times as you want. Replaces a given string with whatever number of times you want. For example, replace SQL Server 2005. This is my string. Okay, from this string, which is the word that I want to replace, 2005, I want to replace this word with 2012. Okay, so it accepts three parameters. The first parameter is the actual string. The second parameter is the old value. And the third parameter is the value you want to replace with. Fine. So the result is SQL Server 2012 database. And the original string was SQL Server 2005 database. So wherever it will come across 2005 will get replaced by 2012. Okay, so instead of manually, let's say I will make it one more time, okay, and we will execute this again. See, wherever it comes across 2005, manually I will not have to change it. I have just used the function once and it will replace all the occurrences. Okay. Then there is one more called as char index. It is used to find the position of the character. Let's say I'm saying starting from 3.
Can I request you to stop for today in SQL and we join back after say 30 minutes for Excel just for today? Because I was not prepared little bit. I the place where I sit and the position of my laptop and microphone and this thing. So I'm in a very awkward this thing here. So I will ready the thing in subsequent 15-20 minutes so that I can listen to the lecture properly. And I just came from office and so probably so what time we start Excel?
8 o'clock. After half an hour.
After half an hour? Okay. So there's a separate link for Excel, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Is Swati coming?
Yeah, she's coming.
Okay.
That's what she told me. Okay.
Okay. Fine.
Okay, thank you. Bye.
Okay.